मैम आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही।
लास्ट लास्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ द एक्सरसाइज, इट वाज गोइंग ऑन चैप्टर 9। लेट अस कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम देयर। द एंगल्स ऑफ एलिवेशन ऑफ द टॉप ऑफ ए टावर फ्रॉम ए पॉइंट एट अ डिस्टेंस ऑफ 4 मीटर एंड 9 मीटर अवे फ्रॉम द बेस ऑफ द टावर आर एंड इन द सेम स्ट्रेट लाइन विद इट आर कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री। इन वन लाइन ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन इज गिवन। लेट अस सी दैट व्हाट he wants to say. He says there is a tower, so let us make a tower. Right? Angle of elevation of the top of the tower. This top of the tower, it is being observed from the points on the ground. But he says angle of elevation of the top of the tower from two points at a distance of 4 meter and 9 meter away from the base of the tower. Two points, one is at a distance of 4 meter from the foot of the tower, and another point is at a distance of 9 meter from the foot of tower. From these two points, the top of the tower, it is being observed. There is a tower, I have taken it to be AB, and there are two points on the ground. One is C, another is D. C is 4 meter away from the foot of the tower, while D is 9 meter away from the foot of the tower. From these two points, the top of the tower is observed. And you know, whenever we are observing something which is at the top or whether at the bottom, especially which is at the top, then we have angle of elevation, right? And whenever we are observing something which is at the bottom and the person is at the top who is observing, then we have angle of depression. And what he is talking about angle of elevation? He says angle of elevation of these two points while the top of the tower is being observed are complementary. This time, the value of the angle is not given in the numerical form. Rather, it is told to us that these angles, they are complementary. So complementary means if I am taking one angle to be theta, then another should be 90 minus theta. One angle is theta, then another should be 90 minus theta. And what he says, what you want to find, prove that height of the tower is 6 meter. Hame is tower ki height ko 6 meter prove karna hai. That means in other words, we'll find the height of the tower and it should be, the answer should be 6 meters. Hamare paas 6 meter answer hona chahiye टावर की हाइट का। तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू विल राइट दैट ए बी इज अ टावर एंड सी एंड डी विद द टू पॉइंट्स ऑन द ग्राउंड सच दैट ए सी इज इक्वल टू 4 एंड ए डी इज इक्वल टू 9 मीटर, राइट? एंड एंगल सी ए सी बी इज इक्वल टू थीटा एंड एंगल ए डी बी इज इक्वल टू 90 माइनस थीटा as the angles they are given to be complementary. Again, with the same line of action, we'll do the solution that there are two triangles, we'll consider two triangles. One triangle I'm considering it to be BAC and another triangle I'm considering it to be BAD. Can anyone tell me that in this question, what we have assumed? Kaun si cheez humne assume ki hai? Kaun si cheez bilkul bhi question mein nahi thi, that is truly my assumption. कैन एनिमल टेल मी, ऐसी कोई चीज जो क्वेश्चन में बिल्कुल नहीं थी उसको मैंने अपनी तरफ से अज्यूम किया है? रेज योर हैंड इफ यू कैन गिव द आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन। केशव कालरा, बच्चे यू अनम्यूट योर सेल्फ। केशव कालरा, केशव केशव कालरा, माधव माधव,
एम एंगल थीटा
थीटा, who is giving the answer?
मैम माधव।
ओके, माधव इज गिविंग द आंसर दैट वी हैव अज्यूम्ड, वी हैव सपोज दिस थीटा, थीटा इज आवर अजम्पशन, वी डोंट नो द एंगल, वी हैव टेकन इट टू बी थीटा। सो यू नो इन मैथ्स व्हाट इज द प्रोसीजर एंड व्हाट शुड बी द लाइन ऑफ एक्शन? वट एवर वी हैव अज्यूम्ड, वट एवर वी हैव सपोज्ड, इन द एंड दैट इज टू बी एलिमिनेटेड। अगर आपने थीटा को एज्यूम किया है तो उस थीटा को ही हमने गायब कर देना है। ये ही हमारे क्वेश्चन का, जो आप कह सकते हो, विनिंग सिचुएशन होगी. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम कंसिडरिंग ट्राइंगल बी ए सी, टेकिंग बी ए सी, दिस इज परपेंडिकुलर ओवर बेस, दिस इज टैन, दिस टाइम एंगल इज थीटा, सो आई एम राइटिंग इट टू बी टैन थीटा. बी ए इज द हाइट ऑफ द टावर, लेट अस सपोज इट टू बी एच, एच मान लो आप इसको, एच ए सी इज फोर, दिस इज टैन थीटा, लेट इट बी इक्वेशन नंबर वन. सो यू आर गेटिंग इक्वेशन नंबर वन बाई डूइंग सो. सो द नेक्स्ट ट्राइंगल इज ट्राइंगल बी ए डी, दिस triangle BAD. Let us consider triangle BAD. And in this triangle BAD, again, this is perpendicular. That means AB over base. That means AD. And this time, theta is 90 minus theta. AB is H and AD is consisting of two parts. AB and, AD full हमें पता है 9. This is equal to, can anyone tell me what is tan 90 minus theta? If you recall the complementary ratio we have done earlier, अगर आपको याद आ रही हो complementary ratios हमने की थी chapter 8 में, can anyone tell me that the tan is rotated by 90 degree, what answer we are getting? Ashima is raising hand, let me ask from Ashima. Yes Ashima, what is tan 90 minus theta?
Ma'am, cot theta.
बिल्कुल ठीक, cot theta. If co is not there, उसको लगा दो, you wish enter in the, you can say complementary ratio, right? Now one thing you see here very carefully, we have to eliminate, that means hame pure expression mein se h chahiye, theta we don't, we are not in need of theta, right? So is theta ko hum kaise gayab karenge? So aapko pata hai tan aur cot ek dusre ko kaise cancel karte hain? If we add tan and cot, will they cancel each other? Never. If we subtract them, even then they will not cancel each other. If we, you can say, divide them, then maybe some possibility. But if we multiply them, then definitely tan and cot, they will cancel each other. So this observation, or you can say this understanding, is telling me that I should multiply these two equations. So what I should write? 1 into 2 gives. 1 into 2 gives. Left hand side, multiply by left hand side. And right hand side, multiply by right hand side. So you will be having. Yes, Raghav, anything you want to say?
हम जो सेकंड इक्वेशन है उसको हम सिंपलीफाई कर सकते हैं cot थीटा को 1 ओवर tan थीटा करके, अभी तो उससे tan थीटा 9 ओवर h आ जाएगा.
अच्छा हां, ये भी वैसे बात ठीक है, दैट वी आर हियर ऑन द सेकंड इक्वेशन, सो यू चेंज इट टू 1 ओवर tan थीटा एंड यूज द वैल्यू ऑफ इक्वेशन नंबर 1. बिल्कुल ठीक, 1 बाय tan थीटा है तो आप यहां से वैल्यू tan थीटा की यूज कर लो, h बाय 9. tan theta is 1 by, tan theta is h by 4, so 1 by tan theta is 4 by h. Theek hai, this is also one way. Instead of doing multiplication, you use equation number 1, changing tan to cot to tan and getting the value, replacing the value of tan from equation number 1. So you will be having h square is equal to 36. H is equal to plus minus 36. When square root shift on another side, we get the two values. But one thing we have to keep in mind, that height is always positive, so negative sign will reject. So value of h is equal to 6. Hence proved, height of the tower, it comes out to be 6 meters. So there are so many examples in this exercise which you can try yourself. Make the figures first. Firstly, learn how to make the figures correctly, right? And then how to solve them. Okay, this is all about with the chapter as far as NCERT book is concerned. So today we'll start with the next chapter, and that is AP. Let us start. Arithmetic, AP, AP here. AP, if I say the full form of these two words, it is arithmetic progression. Arithmetic progression. Now progression को अगर हम simple words में देखें, then meaning of this word progression is series. And when we are talking about series, one thing came in our mind, that is pattern. Right? So series is that, you can say series is that mathematical expression which is following certain pattern. जहां पे कोई pattern follow होता हो हम उसको बोलते हैं that throughout the you can say numbers if the pattern is followed then we say then it is series. So there are so many kind of series. So I would like to start with certain examples, then we will do the definition of AP so that you can through those examples you should reach the definition of AP, right? In your daily life, you around you in real life you see so many examples in which you can say that the things they are formed in the certain patterns. You see the you can say cones on the cob pe jo cones lage hue hain, they are having certain pattern, right? You can see the slices of pineapple, they are you can say revolving with a certain pattern. You can see, moreover, you can see ladder of your house, right? Aise jo ladder hai uske rungs, they are in a certain pattern, right? So there are so many examples in our daily life which tells us that we see certain you can say pattern in materialistic object. Not only in materialistic object, while in some doings or in some daily doings of our, we apply a certain pattern. For example, suppose a person is starting collecting money in the piggy bank, starting with 100 rupees, and suppose starting with 500 rupees, and he is deciding that he will put 100 rupees every month. Every month he is putting 100 rupees in the piggy bank. So when he is putting every month 100, the money in the piggy bank, if we see in the successive months, first month, second month, third month, eighth month, it is forming a certain pattern. It is forming a certain sequence. So not only in the materialistic world, rather in our daily doing also, we use directly or indirectly, knowingly or unknowingly, we use a certain kind of series, certain kind of patterns. Now, out of this, when we say that a pattern or a series is an AP, let me tell you. It is a list of numbers in which each successive term is obtained by adding fixed term in the preceding term. So right now I have written just the you can say definition. I will explain it. Listen, what I want to say, what I have written, what is the meaning of this? It is a list of numbers. First of all, what is AP? It is list of numbers. So we are working in math, so naturally it will be list of numbers. It will not be the list of suits or sarees, right? It is a list of number. What is AP? It is a list of number with special kind of you can say rule, with special kind of categories, but in which each successive term is obtained by adding a fixed number in the preceding term, in which each successive term is obtained by adding a fixed number in the preceding term. Let me give you an example. suppose I am taking one term of an AP, that means 3, and then I would like to write it as 7, then 11, then 15, then 19, and so on. So what we are observing, this is the first term of the AP, starting term always known as the first term, and then second term, third term, fourth term, fifth term, and so on. If I am talking about the second term, this second term is obtained when I am adding 4 to 3. Preceding term means successive term is obtained by adding a constant to the preceding term. That constant should remain the same. Then I say that I'm adding 4 to 7, I'm getting 11. Then I say that I'm getting, I'm adding 4 to 11, I'm getting 15. Adding 4 to 15, I'm getting 19, and so on. Every time what we see that a fixed number is added up to get the particular term. Particular term ko find karne ke liye, we have added up the fixed term. So what is this fixed term known as? Let me tell you. This fixed term is known as common difference. So instead of using the word difference, I'm using here common difference. What is the difference between these two? Instead of writing difference, I'm writing common difference. This word common signify here that difference will remain the same, that will remain the common. Any two consecutive term you take, you find that the difference between these two will remain common. 7 minus 3, you're getting 4. 11 minus 7, again getting 4. 15 minus 11, 4. Every time, same distance is appearing, and this term, this fixed distance is known as common difference of the AP. Fixed difference is known as common difference of the AP. Now, one thing might be in your mind that if we are considering an AP, then common difference, is it positive every time? No, it's not so. Let me explain how. There are so many ways to write AP, right? Suppose I'm writing it like this, 100, 70, 40, 30, and so on. Now, in this list also, the numbers, they are following certain pattern, right? 100, may say 30 minus hua, 70, then 40, then 10, right? So, I said that fixed difference is the common difference of the AP. Isko thoda sa complete kare. It is generally denoted by D. D jahan pe likha hota hai, that is called common difference of AP. And how it is obtained? By subtracting two consecutive terms. Yani ki agar aapne is AP ka common difference nikalna hai, aap koi bhi do consecutive terms lo. Consecutive terms in the, I mean to say, 7 minus 3. Do consecutive terms, second and first. You can take fourth and third. You can take fifth and fourth. And when you will subtract them, you will get the common difference. So if I'm considering this AP, let me find the common difference. This is 70 minus 100 and it comes out to be minus 30. On the other hand, when I was considering the previous AP and I find the common difference, this is 7 minus 3, this is equal to 4. This is positive, right? So this is a positive common difference in the first example. And the second example I'm taking, you see negative common difference. There are one more example is there. Now this is also an AP. You might say that the terms are same, but how we can say there is no distinction between the terms? How we can say that this series is an AP? Because it also follows the rule of the AP. What is the rule of the AP? Difference between two consecutive terms should be same. So aap koi bhi do terms uthao, if you see the difference between them, that is equal to zero. So by giving you these three examples, I just want to conclude that when we are having an AP, then the common difference of the AP, it can be positive, negative, or it can be zero as well. Common difference ki value aapke paas positive bhi aa sakti hai, negative bhi aa sakti hai, and zero bhi common difference ka jo answer hai wo ho sakta hai. Right? So, abhi tak humne sikha, AP is such kind of progression in which the successive term is obtained by adding a fixed term in the preceding term. Adding a fixed number in the preceding term. And that fixed number is known as common difference of the AP. And this common difference, this can be positive, negative, and zero as well. Right? So, you know, whenever we discuss some new concept, we have to learn some abbreviation for the different kind of, you can say, elements of the concepts. If I am talking about AP, मैंने 3 का टेबल लिख दिया, वो भी अपने आप में एक एपी फॉलो करता है क्योंकि इसमें दोनों टर्म्स के बीच में डिफरेंस जो है वो कॉमन होता है, 3 होता है। तो यहाँ पे आपने कुछ एब्रीविएशन याद रखनी है। फर्स्ट टर्म जनरली वी टेक इट टू बी ए, ठीक है, फर्स्ट टर्म जनरली वी टेक इट टू बी ए। सेकेंड कॉमन डिफरेंस, the abbreviation of the common difference generally we take it to be small d, right? Sometimes we are discussing two APs in particular question, kabhi kabhi kuch questions pe do APs at a time discuss karni padti hai, us case mein aap dusre AP first term ko capital A aur dusre AP ke common difference ko capital D bhi le sakte ho, theek hai, that hardly matters, that I will tell you according to the situation, but it is not you can say every time it is not we are not bound ki hame small a and small d hi lene hai, agar do APs ho to hum capital A and capital D bhi le sakte hain. Now there are so many terms of this AP, वैसे तो first term ko hum A kehte hain, but hum first term ko hum A suppose karte hain, iska naam kaise likhte hain, A1, A ke niche first term, second term A2. अच्छा मुझे एक बात बताओ, अगर AP की first term A है, common difference D है, तो सेकेंड टर्म क्या आएगी? फर्स्ट टर्म इज ए, कॉमन डिफरेंस डी, व्हाट शुड बी द आंसर ऑफ द सेकेंड टर्म? एनीवन? हरजोत सिंह, यस हरजोत, यू टेल।
ए प्लस डी,
बिल्कुल ठीक, कॉमन डिफरेंस, एक फिक्स डिफरेंस को ऐड करते जाते हैं, फिक्स नंबर को ऐड करते जाते हैं, प्रीवियस टर्म में ए में डी एड हुआ, वी आर गेटिंग इट टू बी ए प्लस डी। So third term is denoted by A, fix में जाके 3. So can anyone tell me what will be the third term of the AP? What will be the third term of the AP? Yes, Prapreet. हाँ जी Prapreet, you tell.
Ma'am, A plus 2D.
Prapreet, आपका homework नहीं बेटी अभी तक आया.
Okay ma'am, मैं अभी check कर लेती हूँ, मैंने send तो किया था.
मेरे पास नहीं पहुंचा, मैंने आज लिस्टें देनी है, एज अर्ली एज पॉसिबल प्लीज इन्फॉर्म मी अकॉर्डिंगली, ठीक है? बिल्कुल ठीक, आपने बताया प्रीवियस टर्म में डी ऐड होगा, इफ द प्रीवियस टर्म इज ए प्लस डी, आई एम एडिंग डी टू इट, आई विल गेट इट टू बी ए प्लस टू डी, एंड सो इन दिस वे यू कैन फाइंड इनफाइनाइट मैनी टर्म्स ऑफ एपी, राइट? सो ये तो दो एब्रीविएशन तो ये हो गई कि टर्म्स को कैसे डिनोट करते हैं, ए वन ए टू ए थ्री ए फोर एंड सो ऑन, दिस इज एब्रीविएशन ऑफ कॉमन डिफरेंस, एंड द थर्ड आई एम राइटिंग जर्नल फॉर्म ऑफ एपी, जर्नल फॉर्म ऑफ एपी विद फर्स्ट टर्म ए, कॉमन डिफरेंस डी, विद फर्स्ट टर्म ए कॉमन डिफरेंस डी, जर्नल फॉर्म ऑफ एन एपी विद फर्स्ट टर्म ए एंड कॉमन डिफरेंस डी विल बी रिटन एज ए, ए प्लस डी, ए प्लस टू डी, ए प्लस थ्री डी एंड सो ऑन। सो फर्स्ट एक्सरसाइज इज जस्ट बेस्ड ऑन दिस जर्नल फॉर्म दैट आई हैव रिटन, that if you are having the first term, how to find the second, third, fourth and so on. Term kaise find karte hain AP ki? That means every time when you need to find term of AP, two things are needed, two things are required, two things should be with you, that means first term and the common difference. If you know the first term and the common difference, very easily you can write an AP, or you can find the terms of AP. So it's all the game of the first term and the common difference. You know this, you can design AP, right? So first exercise is based on all these concepts, that with the help of the first term and common difference, how you will be able to find an AP. This is the concept of AP, and these are the certain applications, certain marking you have to remember for the questions. Chaliye, let us start with exercise 5.1, which is based on all this theory. Chaliye, exercise 5.1. you know, board is thinking about that the first term of the student, it should be taken in the MCQ form, 90 MCQ and all that. We don't know exactly what will happen because no final approval is there. This is just a suggestion or just, you can say, an application till now. Okay, but if the question paper is in the MCQ form, then each and every concept matters a lot. That is common difference, kaise find karte hain, first term kya hoti hai, second term. To acche se jo bhi theory aapko, tabhi aapko kehte hain classes lagaya karo. Haan ji, Kanishka, any doubt?
Yes, ma'am, jo hamara November mein board zone hai, uska syllabus kya hai?
Abhi bache, board is just suggesting this, that it might happen ki 90 marks ka जो आपका एमसीक्यू बोर्ड का नवंबर में होगा, बट अभी कोई उसका अप्रूवल नहीं आया एंड वेरी सून इट्स जस्ट ऑन द बोर्ड. वेरी सून वी विल गेट द लेटेस्ट सिलेबस एंड अकॉर्डिंगली वी विल इनफॉर्म यू.
ओके, मतलब अभी तक सितंबर का सिलेबस ही है जो करना है?
नहीं, वैसे 10th में ऐसा कुछ होता नहीं है. 10th में वी आर जस्ट मतलब ऑन दिस लाइन कि वी शुड फिनिश द सिलेबस एज अर्ली एज पॉसिबल, बट राइट नाउ वी डोंट नो दैट व्हाट विल बी द सिलेबस ऑफ द नवंबर टेस्ट, सो वी आर गोइंग अकॉर्डिंगली.
ओके, थैंक यू मैम.
एज वी कम टू नो वी विल डेफिनेटली टेल यू. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट विद एक्सरसाइज 5.1. That's why I'm telling you, attend each and every class. Whatever teacher is teaching you, that can turn to an MCQ. If there is 90 marks MCQ paper. तो वहां पे आपकी जो बाद में हमें लगता है कि एक दिन में हम सारी बुक पढ़ जाएंगे और काम बन जाएगा, वो थ्योरी आपकी चलने वाली नहीं है. यू हैव टू लर्न द थिंग्स माइन्यूटली एंड दैट यू कैन डू ओनली विद द हेल्प ऑफ टीचर. सो डू अटेंड योर क्लासेस. क्वेश्चन नंबर फर्स्ट. In which of the following situation does the list of the numbers involved make an arithmetic progression and why? We are given certain situations and we have to tell whether these situations, they lead to the example of AP or not. First part, the taxi fare after each kilometer, when the fare is rupees 15 for the first kilometer. Let me write fare for first kilometer का फेयर मेरी first term बन जाएगी एपी की. A1 कह दो इसको. This will be 15. And after every kilometer, that means if I'm traveling 2 kilometer, then 8 rupees will be you can say charge extra. 3 kilometer तो और 8 add हो जाएगा. 4 kilometer will add on one more 8 and so on. Fare for second kilometer. That is A2. Every time 8 is added, that is 23. And fare for third kilometer, that is A3, and that is equal to 23 plus 8. That is 31. And so on. Zaruri nahi ki aap sabhi ke liye likho. Now you just ek term chalo aur likh lo. Fare for the fourth kilometer. And mark it to be A4. This is equal to 31 plus 8, that is equal to 39, and so on. Now you find the difference between the two consecutive terms. So you write here A2 minus A1, this is equal to 23 minus 15, 8. A3 minus A2, this is equal to 31 minus 23, that is 28. And then A4 minus A3, that is 39 minus 31, that is 28, and so on. So in the last you will write, as here the difference between two consecutive terms remains the same, so we can say that the given situation is making an AP. Given situation is making an AP, or you can say that arithmetic progression is formed with the given situation, right? So certain parts are left. Isme se main aapko second and fourth part I'll teach. Third, you will try. So this is all about it today's lecture. Always remember, attending the classes is as important as we are breathing, right? Jitna saans lena hamare liye zaruri hai, utna hi class attend karna hamare liye zaruri hai. So always be on screen whenever your teachers, they are starting with the Zoom meeting. It is a very good feeling when you see your students, they are waiting in waiting room for your lecture, right? So take care. Bye-bye. We'll meet tomorrow.